Good morning, everyone. I'm here today to share some good news for the city of Calgary, but as Nahid said, today is also a profoundly sad day. Last night, after days of exhaustive searching, we learned that Calgary police found the body of Talia Marshman. And she was a beautiful child, as are all children, with a full and promising life ahead of her. I want Calgarians to know that the entire country is with you in grieving her loss and that of her mother, Sarah. I want to extend a special thanks to Calgary Police, who I know have poured their hearts into this investigation and who are especially devastated by last night's news. And finally, to the family and friends of Sarah and Talia, I am so deeply sorry for the loss of two people whom you loved and loved you. Families across this country, parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, siblings, are grieving alongside you, thinking of you, praying for you. I hope you can someday find some peace through your sadness. And we are also thinking of our friends in France, where last night more than 80 people, including many children, were killed in a terrorist attack in Nice. Les victimes sont des familles qui célébraient leur fête nationale comme plusieurs d'entre nous ont célébré la nôtre il y a deux semaines aujourd'hui. Nous avons tous participé à ce genre de célébration. On fait notre chemin dans la foule en se bousculant. On danse sur les refrains de musique qu'on connaît bien. On repousse l'heure de se coucher pour les plus petits pour qu'ils puissent voir les feux d'artifice. Et à la fin de la soirée, on rentre à la maison avec nos enfants endormis dans nos bras. C'est eux qui ont été ciblés. C'est eux qui ont été attaqués. Et c'est avec une très grande détermination que nous offrons au gouvernement français toute l'aide possible. Nous allons travailler avec nos alliés afin de combattre le terrorisme sous toutes ses formes et de traduire les responsables en justice. And now, on to the reason for my visit today. I want to first thank Premier Notley, Mayor Nenshi, and Tsuut'ina Nation Chief Roy Whitney for being here. When I was being honored a few months ago by the Tsuut'ina Nation, Chief Roy and I chatted quite a bit about the project we're confirming today. I also want to acknowledge the Provincial Minister of Transportation and Minister of Infrastructure, Brian Mason, and the Federal Minister of Infrastructure and Communities, Amarjeet Sohi. And finally, our great local MP for Calgary Centre, Minister of Veterans Affairs, Kent Hare. Good to have you here, Amarjeet and Kent. Kent, thanks for all the hard work that you and Darshan Kang have put into making this announcement possible. I know that during Stampede Week, people typically expect a visiting politician to do two things: flip pancakes and look awkward in a really big hat. Well, I ticked off both those boxes this morning, which frees me up now to make this important announcement. And while I want to be very clear that the news we are sharing today, while very important to the city of Calgary and the people who live here, is new, it's not something that you'll be hearing about for the very first time. Last summer, the previous government announced plans to invest up to $583 million in the construction of the southwest portion of the Calgary Ring Road. And today, I'm happy to announce that our government will be moving ahead with this project. We've completed the necessary reviews, and the project has now met all the requirements and conditions for funding under the 2014 new Building Canada plan. Early work on the Southwest Calgary Ring Road is now underway. Je suis heureux d'annoncer que toutes les étapes ont maintenant été complétées et que les travaux du tronçon sud-ouest de la voie de contournement de Calgary, représentant un investissement de $583 million, sont maintenant en cours. For the city of Calgary, it means a new large-scale highway and the completion of a plan that has been in the works since the 1970s. For local businesses, it means better and faster access to markets, whether goods are traveling across the province or across the country, to trading partners in North America or around the world. For the citizens of Calgary and surrounding communities, it means less time spent waiting in traffic and more time spent with family and friends. And that's not time in an abstract sense. The average Calgarian spends nearly an hour commuting to and from work every day. An hour every day commuting to and from work. That's almost 10 full days spent commuting every year. That's time that would be better spent playing with your kids at Prince's Island, or shopping at the farmer's market, or volunteering in the community. A project like the Southwest Calgary Ring Road will help to make that possible. L'entente de transfert de terre négociée entre la nation Tsutina et la province de l'Alberta est un élément essentiel à la réalisation de ce projet qui encouragera la croissance économique et créera des opportunités pour la communauté. Cette initiative est aussi avantageuse pour l'environnement. Une circulation plus fluide aidera à réduire les émissions de gaz à effet de serre et à améliorer la qualité de l'air. Et l'industrie du tourisme en tirera également profit. Grâce à cette nouvelle route, les voyageurs pourront plus facilement visiter les superbes parcs nationaux de l'Alberta et de la Colombie-Britannique. For all these reasons, and because we know that infrastructure investments like this one can create good, well-paying jobs that help the middle class and those working hard to join it, we are proud to do our part, along with the province and the city, to make good on this promise. Thank you all once again for joining with us today. I'm now happy to call upon my friend, Premier Rachel Notley.